Earlier today, at 11:23 a.m. local time, Italy's famed Mount Etna volcano produced a several hundred degrees Celsius pyroclastic flow which raced down its eastern slopes at high speeds, sending hundreds of tourists in the vicinity panicking, causing them to rapidly flee in the opposite direction. Moving at a speed of 87.2 miles per hour or 140.4 kilometers per hour, this superheated gas current, which was a mixture of scorching hot lava, hard rock, ash, deadly superheated volcanic gases, and regular air, traveled 2.34 kilometers or 1.45 miles in only 60 seconds. By the time this pyroclastic flow eventually came to a full halt 84 seconds later, it had traveled a full 3.26 kilometers or 2.03 miles, incinerating an area of 2.64 square kilometers or 1.02 square miles. I am quite loosely using the term incinerated here because the affected sector of the volcano had no vegetation, being so frequently inundated by such lava flows that no plants grow there. In fact, during today's eruption, another such lava flow began at around 5 a.m. local time, and by 7 hours later, it had traveled a full 2.7 kilometers via about the extent I have geolocated here. While it is difficult to see the lava on social media footage, what you can see is the white gas rising from the lava flow tongue or furthest extent, which has at least 4 current lobes. The area in question is known as Valle del Bove, which represents a landslide scar from 7200 BCE when 25 cubic kilometers of the volcano slid away into the Mediterranean Sea, creating a tsunami that affected the entire basin. While there is no such landslide ongoing today, the area simply serves as a low point that so many recent lava flows have been funneled into due to its shape. Because so many lavas in Valle del Bove are so young, they are still cooling and thus unsafe to walk on, and that is why there are zero open hiking trails in its middle and upper sections. This fact is why, despite the very scary videos and images that widely circulate on social media, no one, at least to the best of my knowledge, was injured or worse from the pyroclastic flow today. However, based on attempted geolocation efforts, groups of tourists at times may have been as close as half a mile away from the advancing pyroclastic flow, albeit to its edge, where it was not rapidly advancing. How did all this happen, and why exactly did a pyroclastic flow occur this morning, which was the longest traveling of its kind at Mount Etna during at least the last 35 years? After all, as of yesterday morning, Etna was fairly quiet with only very low-level activity. The answer is that Etna somewhat suddenly produced a type of intense eruptive activity that it is quite known for, that being known as a paroxysm. Paroxysms are essentially short yet violent bursts of activity that occur in between the volcano's more quiet periods, and these paroxysms can take multiple forms. These paroxysms can create strombolian or volcanian eruptions that sometimes generate pyroclastic flows, flank lava flows, which may even originate from cinder cones in rare circumstances, and in their very rarest of circumstances, even subplinian or plinian eruptions. Despite the generation of a lengthy pyroclastic flow, you might be surprised to learn that today's eruption was primarily a strombolian one and one with a lengthy summit-based lava flow, specifically from its southeast crater. But wait, you might say, strombolian eruptions aren't generally associated with pyroclastic flows. And that is true. However, there are four main ways pyroclastic flows or surges can form, and one of these can happen during strombolian eruptions, with that being a lava flow or vent collapse if it becomes too steep. You might have noticed that today's pyroclastic flow had a strong reddish-brown tint to it, suggesting it contained a high amount of scoria. Although it is difficult to be sure how much of Etna's southeast crater was removed by the pyroclastic flow, we can say that it originated somewhere between the main vent to 250 meters north-northeast of it. The paroxysm which started all of this began around 8 p.m. local time yesterday on June 1st and seemingly peaked around the same time the pyroclastic flow occurred. While it is unknown how much longer the ongoing paroxysm will last for, generally speaking, recent paroxysms at Etna have either been followed by a decent duration lull of no or weak eruptive activity, or are followed within 48 hours by another paroxysm. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube for supporting my work.